Right, so now we are on a project where we've actually done some work. So this is not a brand new project, it's a work in progress. And you're also going to meet some of my JV partners. So let's come along with me and I'll show you. Hi team, so here we are and we are in one of our HMO projects here right now. And we have, as you can see, we have...
Sheila.
We have...
Hi.
And we have...
Hi, Bupinda here.
Yeah, so some of our JV partners, we've got Nick here, of course.
Hi team.
Who's helping out as well. So yeah, so here we are in the HMOs. Questions, comments, suggestions?
No, I just think if it's an under the radar at HMO, do we still have to have a smoke detector in each room?
Mm. So answer for that one is yes. So it's actually not a, it's a smoke. Yeah, you've got a lot. If I show you the ceiling, look quickly, if I can show you. Am I showing you the ceiling? That's my nose I'm showing you. Yeah. Right, let me show you the ceiling.
Yeah.
There, right, so. Yeah, the smoke alarms are mandatory in all the bedrooms, and this is one of the bedrooms. So this was actually the lounge, and now this is becoming a bedroom. Now there's been a lot of work going on. You can't often tell the amount of work that's gone on after the finishing plaster is there, but this has all been taken back to brick. The property's already been rewired. It's in the at the first fix stage, so that is the sockets haven't gone on, but all the wiring has been done. So that's where we are right now, and we are actually in the first bedroom of the property. So we just walk through the door, and on the right hand side, we're in this property. And already, Sheila's asking questions.
So what was the reason for not...
Because that's Sheila. She just likes to ask questions about everything, isn't it? How long have you been married to the lady?
Yeah, she
40
does.
40 plus years.
Too many questions.
40 plus years, and she's asking questions.
So why have you still kept that, and why haven't you... If that is... The light, why hasn't it moved more central? Or is that one the light?
Yes, so
that's
why?
A thicker wire, right?
Yes, so the light is in the center.
Yes. Yeah,
so and the, what the other one is going to be, you'll see, is a bit of the interior design because we're going to style this one out. Yeah. So this is one of our new HMO models, yeah, where what we've got is a new design. So typically around every sort of decade, we'll change it up a bit. and what I say change it up, it means that we... You know, really make that HMO pedestalized compared to other HMOs in the area, which means that you can actually rent the property because that's important, isn't it? You want to be able to rent it and get a good yield, and you need to be better than the average. That's the way it is. Yeah. So that's what we're doing now. What is Sheila doing here? Because Sheila's having a measurement there.
Yeah. So that is.
This is a new measurement. I've never seen this.
That's a tailor's style measurement.
Yeah. That's very interesting. I've never done that before.
Meter, that's one
and
a half meter. How many feet is that? So that's 3 feet. So yeah,
so a single
bed can fit in there. Easy, yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
So we there's a lot of.
So you can have a bedside cabinet there, and you can have a desk, and it works.
Yes, it does work. Yes.
So are we leaving this in here or moving it?
Yes, the gas meter will stay there. Now, interesting point about the gas meter. So the gas meter is actually in the bedroom. Look, little Danny. Now, what the workaround for this is, as long as we have a break glass where we can say to the tenant that the key is in there with the break glass, so if anybody needs to get in, they can, break glass. And when we sign the tenancy agreement, what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that the tenant is aware of that right at the beginning, and it will be a clause in the contract to say, if we need to enter your room for emergency reasons, then we can. If the gas meter needs to be read, and you'll be given nights for that, but if we need to enter the property and enter the room, then we are able to do that. So that will be a condition before they get the keys.
That's
how it works.
That's a cheaper option, because if you removed it and you put it outside, that's a hefty cost.
Very well said. I wish I could say it like that, yes. Okay, now let's discuss the roof. So there have been some extra challenges. So the roof started to leak, and we've had to pull down the front of the roof. So there's been some extra expenses here, which were unexpected. And these things happen, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, you know, we needed to do it, it needs to be done, and it all comes out of the contingency that we already put in place. Mm-hmm. So all of this, although it looks like it's just plasterboard, actually, the roof at the front of this has actually also been replaced.
The whole of that?
Yes.
It wasn't just a few tiles?
It wasn't a few tiles because the way that whole thing had to be replaced.
Right.
There was a short-term fix, but the short-term fixes usually end up being more expensive. So yeah, so always think about return on investment. You know, what's the best thing to do? And in this case, we had to actually fix that part. We need to be totally repaired. Let's go into the rest of the place.
Yeah,
okay. So as you can see, all the first fixes have been done. So what is first fixes? The first fixes are all the way up to the plaster work. So all the works that you normally don't see, work is done, that is the first fix. Just to clarify. Damp proofing has also been done.
Brilliant.
Yeah, so it's all been damp proofed. Now all this is gonna help with the EPC, of course, to go to a C. We already assessed the EPC to be a C and what needs to be done. So that's happening right now.
So are there any walls that you've changed and put any extra insulation into?
Yes.
Okay, did you take pictures of the extra insulation to show the EPC?
I've been sending them to you every week.
Yeah, just double checking.
Yeah. Like it! Brilliant! So this has ended up having a full central heating system because the old boiler didn't work.
Yeah.
And then the radiators were there, but the radiators were so old. What that would have done is it would have really ruined the new boiler. So we've had to replace the radiators as well. So really, it's a full central heating system. I know why you keep kicking that.
Because
why do you keep kicking the pipes, Sheila? Why?
Because if you don't do that right, then you don't know
So as you can see, double glazed windows in here. So we've had some of the double glazing we're actually doing, which is required because the old double glazing, it was not really fit for purpose. And also, we need a double glazing window, which is going to be a fire window for the upstairs. And in fact, we have it here, which hasn't been fitted yet, but that's going to be fitted. Yeah. So there we have the double glazed window for the fire window that is a requirement for HMOs on the first floor.
Yeah.
Come on, Sheila, have a feel.
No, you can kick it. I only kick the old stuff.
Oh, I see, there's a rule. Let's walk around in the kitchen. Yeah, be very careful where you step with the set again. So now the kitchen here, this has all been damp-proofed. The sockets are in place. Again, we're at the first fixed stage. Now, the ceiling has also been insulated. Now, that's a key one, because these days there's a lot of talk about condensation.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the media as well. So whenever required, wherever you possibly can, insulation, wherever you're going to get condensation, put in insulation. Now, this is a single story, and there will be condensation here. So what we're doing is in the ceiling, as you can see, it's work in progress. There will be insulation in that to reduce condensation. So you won't get the black mold. If you may have seen in some properties, there's black mold in the corners. That won't come back as easily when you have insulation. So yeah, do think about insulation and put it in the right places. Typically, the loft spaces above bathrooms, above kitchens, single stories, it will really help to keep the moisture out. Let's discuss electrics. So earthing is very important. In rental properties, you need the earth wire there. Because last thing you want is people to be, electrical, and it'll be part of the EICR anyway. So, of course, earthing is there. What does that mean? It's this yellow-green wire over here. Yeah, earthing wire, so that the electricity passes to the ground and doesn't pass through somebody like you.
Yeah.
And the bathroom is being renovated. It's going to look amazing once it's all done. So, here, this, why are we doing so much work here? Because what happens with HMOs, like what I say, the average does not work. Today's market, you gotta be just a little bit better. And what we're doing here is we're making a real property that's gonna be amazing for the tenants to be living in. It's gonna not look, it's not gonna look anything like any other HMO around. The interior design, not just the interior design, but the actual, the thought process that's gone into what we've done here is well above, most people, most landlords that are doing HMOs. So what that means is that your property is going to get rented. You know, just do that bit more, secure your income, secure your equity in the property, because the value of the property is also going to go up. When the value comes in, it's going to be wow. So, these are things to be thinking about. And I really hope you're enjoying these tips. And if you are, do like and give me a bit of support as well, because I've been doing this all day. Have you noticed? I can't remember how many projects I've shown you so far. But anyway, yeah, I'll carry on.
I can definitely remember the last time we were here.
Yeah.
The walls obviously they now look different because of all the plastering that's taking place. I'm really excited because I know that I can, obviously I have that feel that it's going to turn out really, really amazing. You know, we'll end up with a high end.
Yeah, it's going to be nice.
I'm really, really excited. I can't wait to see the final fitting. I'm very, very excited.
It's quite difficult to see how much work's gone on, because when the plastering is done, the fact that it's been taken back to brick, the fact that there's been insulation in it as well, that's the fact that there's first fixes.
Yes.
And the thing is, this is, it is a lot of fun.
Yes.
And the key also, of course, is it's not a vanity project. You've got to make some money from this as well, right?
Precisely.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, some figures for you.
Yeah.
So, purchase price of this one. Now, of course, look, we always get the best deals, that we aim to get the best deals possible.
Yes.
And this one here, we purchased for 73.5k.
Yes.
Yes. Mm. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. And once the HMO is occupied, rented, what we will find is the net income after all costs is going to be around the £1,000 a month mark. So that's £12,000 per annum. I mean, how many of these do you really need? That's the thing, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And on top of that, with the amount of work we're doing, every £1 that we spend, we add another £1 to the property.
Another £1,
That's the thing. So the valuation should be a very good valuation. Valuers right now, if I'm being completely honest with you, they're quite, what's the word I'm looking for?
They are undervaluing because they are quite conservative.
That's it, yeah.
Yes.
Exactly. People said that. That's actually what they are. However, they've got to keep it real, and when you've got a very good quality product, then they've got to put a good valuation on it. So maybe we'll do some of these at that point as well.